probably of all the insane things that were faced in the course of making this film, trying to shoot aerials in military airspace in Egypt was by far the biggest challenge.
You can't actually put a person on top of a historical landmark. So they shot the original plate first and then built a smaller set of the top of the Sphinx's head and put Hayden Christensen on that and tried to replicate the same move.
I'm just trying to get a piece of you guys tumbling on the ground. So just make it as messy as possible here that you're rolling around.
It's hard to imagine a film where the first units traveled more places than this movie. I can't even imagine a story that would sort of accommodate that many locations. It's just that we happen to have teleporters, so it's, if you don't have people who can teleport, how would the story go to that many places?
There's one version of this film and that could have been the whole film being shot in Canada with a green screen behind them. It was incredibly important to us that the teleportation to other cities and other worlds be real, be grounded, be textured, be interactive with a real environment, not only in terms of the audience's relationship to these places, which is incredibly important, but also the character's relationship to these places. We wanted the actors to feel like they're really interacting on a Roman street, as opposed to interacting on a Canadian street with Roman, you know, picture cars.
I think that that's how it should be. I'd rather, you know, conserve the money and be clever about how we plan the movie and go there for real rather than fake it in a computer. This is kind of like how they used to do it, you know, many years ago and before the advent of computers. You didn't have a choice. You had to go somewhere. That's the essence of filmmaking, is going to the real place, you know, and trying to create the magic.
This is a movie about, you know, someone who can go anywhere. They can go there, blink of an eye. A dialogue scene that starts here in New York City could continue for four lines of dialogue in Tokyo, and then go to Rome for a minute, and because that's what these characters can do. We went to Tokyo for 2 weeks, we were in Italy for 10 days, we were in Prague for a couple of days. You know, each one of these places with a crew that only spoke that language. France, London, Egypt, Baja, Louisiana, Toronto, Montreal, Detroit, Ann Arbor, New York City, Los Angeles. When you look at the movie, you know, I don't think anyone's ever combined sort of the traveling that the Bond movies or the Bourne movies do with the kind of visual effects that we were doing.